Well, let's change a bit the topic of the session. As Laura said, I'm going to talk about new data, paleoenvironmental data about Corsica that enable the reconstruction of the environmental framework of Neolithisation in the island. Well, just to present the study area, it's located in the western Mediterranean, in the island of Corsica, and we studied in two sites. Saint Florent is located in the north of Corsica, and Piantarella is located in the opposite extreme of the island, in the southern area. In Saint Florent, we studied one core, and in Piantarella, we studied three cores. So in this presentation, we only present two of these three cores. And well, the objective of this work is the reconstruction of vegetation history and climate change in Corsica, and in also in order to evaluate the differences between the north and the south of the island. And one important objective is assess human impact, and we are mainly focused on Neolithic times. And in order to find the earliest evidence of human impact in the island. One important objective, if it was also to obtain first multiproxy sequences in these areas of the island. In the past, there were a lot of studies carried out mainly by Maurice Bailey, but there were all the studies without a good geochronological control, and one of the objectives it was to have a lot of C14 dates in order to have a chronological control of environmental changes. There are some evidences of early Neolithic in Corsica, and the early Neolithic in Corsica is dated more or less between 8,000 to 7,000 before present, and it consists of the cardial well culture. And we have in both areas, near Saint Florent in the north, we have two early Neolithic sites, Stret and Grotesque Talmudio. And in the southern area, we have also two early Neolithic sites, Aralina Senola and the Bonifacio. Well, the materials included in this study, we studied three cores. The first one is in Florent in North Corsica. And we studied, we obtained data of the Middle to Late Neolithic and also in Roman and Middle Ages. And we studied Cerealia-t, Neolithisation, and the evergreen sites, and also pollen and polynomials analysis. In Piantarella 1, we obtained data for the early Neolithic, and we conducted analysis of pollen and loss of ignition and ostracoda and foraminifera. And finally, in Piantarella 3, we obtained data for the middle to late Neolithic, middle and late Neolithic, and we developed loss of ignition, reservoir size, pollen analysis, and macrofaunal analysis. For Piantarella, core 1 in Piantarella in southern Corsica, we applied the study of ostracoda and foraminifera in order to reconstruct the evolution of the environment. And well, in this diagram we can see that in the early Neolithic there was a brackish marine environment, so in the lagoon there was an input of marine water. And then in the transition to the late Holocene, there's a change. It's still a brackish marine environment, but with decreasing diversity of ostracoda. That means that the input of marine water was decreasing. Then in Roman and Middle Ages times, the environment changed to a freshwater lagoon. So the connection with the sea was closed. For the pollen analysis, we can see the open vegetation since the the Early Neolithic, mainly composed by Mediterranean scrublands, composed mainly by Erica and Cistaceae. And we can see also from the Early Neolithic evidences of Cerealia, evidences of agriculture, a permanent signal of Cerealia during the sequence. We can see also in that blue high values of Chenopodiaceae that suggest the existence of a saline environment consisting of marshland. So during the Early Neolithic, we can say that open vegetation existed in southern Corsica, with the doubt, with the question if among Erica species we can have shrubs or Erica arborea that can compose forest, and if there is a doubt if it consisted of shrublands or it could be also an Erica arborea forest, the landscape. But well, the forest would have been dominated by Mesophilus taxa, showing the Mid Holocene climate optimum in this area, with the predominance of broadleaf deciduous trees like deciduous quercus and corylus. And we can see also the early evidence of agriculture and human impact in the southern part of Corsica. The other core study by pollen analysis was Piantarella 3 that provides data for the Middle Neolithic and the Neolithic, and we can see also the same signal, an open vegetation dominated by Erica and Cistaceae, so the dominance of Mediterranean scrublands. And here we can see the reduction of saline indicators, the reduction of Chenopodiaceae, and the increase of freshwater indicators. So we have the same question like in the Early Neolithic. Is there an open vegetation or could be Erica arborea forest? But we found some macrofossils in this sequence in Piantarella 3. And here we have charcoal of Erica and seed of Erica that could be identified at a species level. It's Erica scoparia. That it's a species of Erica that consists of shrubs, not trees. So the hypothesis of the existence of Erica arborea forest would be less probable than the dominance of Mediterranean shrublands. And in this sequence, we can see an important change in the Middle Neolithic. We have the predominance of Mesophilus taxa, showing the Holocene climate optimum. And then in the Late Neolithic, we see a decrease of Mesophilus and the increase of evergreen sclerophyllous, showing the changing climate, maybe showing the decrease in precipitation and the difference between seasons. In this sequence, we also had regular occurrence of Cerealia, showing permanent human impact during Middle Neolithic and Late Neolithic, except in the phase 5800 to 5700. And we can see an increase of fresh water indicators showing this brackish environment that it's in transition to freshwater environment. Well, here in this sequence we can see the integration of both cores of Piantarella 1 and 3, and we can see in red human impact episodes and in dark blue peaks of saline indicators, and in light blue the peaks of freshwater indicators. For Saint Florent, located in the north of the island, we see a very different landscape. We obtain data for the Middle and Late Neolithic in the bottom part of the diagram, and we can see the evergreen sclerophyllous trees, that Quercus ilex coccifera predominated in the landscape, and we see forest environment. It's different with compared with southern Corsica, where Mediterranean shrublands dominated. We see here in northern Corsica first evidence of agriculture in Middle Neolithic. We have cerealia pollen in Middle Neolithic, not in Early Neolithic. Well, in this diagram we can see the in red the human impact changes, and in the environmental change, the most important environmental change is the transition from freshwater environments during Middle Neolithic and Late Neolithic to the input of marine water and the composition of marshlands during Roman and Middle Ages. The integration of all these multi-proxy data allowed us to reconstruct the sea level reconstruction. These are very new data, arrived just yesterday. And well, in blue, in light blue, we can see the data for Northern Corsica, and in red, data for the Southern Corsica. And we can see the evolution of the increasing level of the sea. And just to conclude, some differences are very clear between northern Corsica and southern Corsica, that also show the different climate conditions. In northern Corsica, there were dense forests of evergreen scrofulous trees. And in the southern Corsica area, we find more open vegetation dominated by Mediterranean shrublands, by maquis. And these Mediterranean shrublands would have consisted of the natural vegetation of the southern part of the island since the Middle Holocene. And what we want to highlight with this study is the first evidence of early Neolithic human impact based on palaeo-environmental proxies. And well, the differences between southern Corsica and northern Corsica is that the earliest evidence of human impact is documented in the southern area. And finally, that the multiproxy analysis provided new data for the reconstruction of sea level evolution, and that's a line that we will develop in the future.
Well, thanks for your attention.